Now, with that need for that money, we really need to have this donor money be an open pool, an actual like city budget we can pull from without there being any sort of restrictions. And if not, I could see a scenario down the road where the city becomes so desperate for money that influence, which can creep in many, many ways, will make its footprint known. And again, we could see those very donors exercise disproportionate control compared to the rest of the citizens of Kalamazoo. I want to make it clear, Kalamazoo Community Foundation, they do a lot of great work, and they do a lot of great philanthropy, but there is a difference between people who are rich and happen to be good actors and basic principles of conflict of interest. The Kalamazoo Community Foundation is sprawling, and it funds so many, the majority of the nonprofits, community organizations, churches, etc., in this city. So if you're going to have them pick this board that is going to control the foundation, that's an inherent conflict, because you're asking a group that is already kind of the executor of the donor class in the city to basically continue to do exactly that. I really feel it needs to either be go back to some of their original ideas, where it was the democratically elected commission choosing this board, or get a neutral third party that is not financially tied to the various nonprofits around here to choose those citizens to be on that board. If those safeguards are entrenched there, that makes the fight of the citizens, who are the watchdogs of this inevitably, all that much more difficult. And that needs to be pointed out.